I've just written two lines with an emoji. Really? Oh God, so small.
I think
Python. Okay, Python spelling is wrong. First of all.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again because a vision softly.
Would you like to react to my LinkedIn profile?
I think your LinkedIn is already good, but anyways, let me see.
So this is my profile.
Okay. Okay, perfect. Add cover photo. First thing, okay. My suggestion. You are a YouTuber and you have your YouTube channel. Yeah. So you can have a very awesome cover, like which shows your channel name. And it will have also, like, for example, if I don't know about your YouTube channel, I'm landing on your LinkedIn for the first time. I know this is your YouTube channel.
Okay.
Then your normal photograph. Why it's with other people. I can see hand of someone. I can see someone else photo, like the side cut in face. Like, why?
Yeah. Okay. I need to.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then CS adds bits. Okay. YouTuber, ML plus finance enthusiastic consultant and VC. GCC. What is BGCC? First question. Then I have heard of BCG, but I've never heard of BGCC,
yeah.
Front-end developer. Okay, so you are lacking little bit of keywords in terms of you've just added developer once and you just added front-end developer, add software developer or software engineer or something of that sort, because, and then on the same hand, you have added ML plus finance enthusiast.
Yeah.
So this is actually, according to me, is not a keyword. Because no one will search for ML plus finance enthusiast.
Okay.
And on the same hand, you have added yourself as a developer or engineer or software engineer. Add those skills also. For example, as I mentioned, C++, Java, what you are good at best at and you want to showcase. So add those keywords, like at least 2 to 3 keywords, which you are good at and you can add those. So
okay.
This is where, then can you click on your contact info? This one, like 500, this one. Okay, why you don't have your YouTube channel link here?
I didn't update it.
You should have it.
Yeah,
you should have it. Yeah. So these are the very small things which people don't update, like in general, but they should do it because that is where LinkedIn is providing us like an upper edge and they're giving us benefits. So we should update it as soon as possible. You should add your number. You should add your email is there, but you should add your YouTube. And I think Twitter is good. If you have any GitHub or something, because you're a developer, and if you have that or any other platform where you're posting your projects or something, just add that also. You should pick like 2 to 3, just 2 to 3 relevant. I mean, you can have like web developer, software engineer, and multiple versions of a developer. Then you can have like data analyst, data scientist, like at least similar things. These are like 5 entirely different domain experiences. I'm not saying you should not explore, but they're like completely different and completely different domains. So this is, I think, like something which I can say. Can we go to the summary?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh God, so small.
Yeah.
Okay. This. Okay. So expand this as much as you can. Add in how someone should contact you. Add your YouTube link. Add your GitHub link, add your, what you have worked also as, do you have any other link also?
And all the same. We haven't updated it for almost a year now. So I think.
Python. Okay. Python spelling is wrong. First of all.
Yeah.
So again, here one more thing. Whenever you're writing anything in your resume and your LinkedIn, pass it through Grammarly.
Yeah,
that is really, really important because Grammarly will tell you your grammar is wrong or not. Because a lot of times we write the English and English is not correct. Okay, let's go to the featured section. Can you just scroll down more? Okay, the first one is, Can you just move to the right, like other, okay, GitHub, and you have added like the liked one. Experience part first and then maybe we can go to the other section. Okay. You have not added any content. What you're doing from last 8 months, project Kratos as a team member, what you were doing. There's no content here. Then what are you doing as a senior consultant from 9 months?
Okay, yeah.
Then can you just scroll? I'm working with 25. Okay. You're working as a junior consultant.
Yeah.
As a part-time. You've just written 2 lines with an emoji. Really?
with
an emoji, you have written just 2 lines. This is like epic. This is something. Okay. Please.
Yeah.
You are interested in so many things, but I can't see a single keyword to any of these roles.
Mm-hmm.
Not a single word I've seen from your, like, from your header till here. Not a single word anywhere. If you search for a software engineer, your profile won't be shown. If we search for a data analyst, your profile won't be shown. If we search for a consultant, your profile won't be shown. Okay, just update it. This is what I can say as of now.
Yeah, like I'll have
okay.
to.
In education, in education section, add 3-4 lines about your university.
Okay.
What exactly is BITS Pilani? Because, for example, someone outside India, they should know what is BITS Pilani. Even in India, they should kind of so add that. Add, like, if you click on the pencil part, like, yeah, this one. So, can you scroll down? Scroll more down. Add your grade here. Don't add in your resume if it's below 9.5, but add, you can add it here. Add your activities and schools. So, all the things what you have written there, na, core members, add it here.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then add the descriptions also. So remove it from the experience part, because they are actually not actual work experience. You understand what I'm trying to do? You just added your clubs or memberships and all those things in the work experience, but they are not actually, they are your extracurricular activities, right? They are not actually your proper work experience, because you are just in second year. So you need to understand the difference between these two things, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So add it here, expand this whole thing. Certificates, I think it's fine. You've added a lot of them. Can we scroll down further? Yeah. Yeah, teacher, what you're doing. We go to teach student. Add 2-3 pointers. I mean, you're doing it and you are teaching and it's a good thing. You should like focus on this. Just add 2-3 lines in a good way that what you're teaching, how you're benefiting, how you're helping. And just also add that it's an NGO, because I can know, but you have not written that since till the time person clicks on it. So just add that it's an NGO helping these, add 2-3 lines about the NGO and then write what you're doing.
Okay.
Then add the skills. Take these skill quizzes, basically. They've added because it will help you to improve your skills section. I can just see like very less people have endorsed you for different skills. So ask more your like college friends and your peers to endorse you more for more and more skills. So your skills section will look much, much more beautiful and look good, basically. Right now, it's just like 3-4 people have clicked on it. Hindi or English. Okay. The projects, can you just click on the projects? First of all, this is my suggestion to everyone who's watching this. Add your experience, your projects and everything in a bullet point. So right now I can see 3 pointers in one line. 3 different sentences you have added together and made them. So instead of that, break them in smaller sentences and have them as a bullet point, which is easy for recruiter or hiring manager to read. And as I'm saying again and again, make an impact, like as an ad, for example, your coding or your automation has improved the efficiency by 90%. So just write that. I have automated and wrote a code and that has improved the efficiency, or it has helped the team to reduce the turnaround time by 5 hours. It has improved the efficiency by 90%. So that kind of sentence will make an impact. Right now, whatever you have written, I know that you're doing a good job, but you have not put it in a right way. You're not put it in a way that will make like any recruiter to reach out to you. It is good that you've added the links. That's a good part. Like everyone should do that, that you've added the links so that the person can click on the project and they can go to the link.
Yeah,
Okay, for the interest and the hashtags, follow as many companies as you can, follow as many people as you can. When you do that, like if they have any update, it will show in your homepage, in your profile, I mean, in your wall. And also follow hashtag. For example, if you just write in your search at the top, hashtag Amazon jobs. Like if you write, yeah, hashtag Amazon jobs. Yeah, click on it. Yeah, follow.
Okay.
So now when you do all these things, you will see all the updates of the people, basically. You will see notifications and everything. And this is where basically you should do that. You should follow as many as you can.